Next, we place four columns to create a veranda on the south side of the building. The first and the last column will align with the axis of the two walls, and they will be equally distributed and run parallel to the front wall. Switch to the zero ground floor in the Navigator project map. Activate the column tool in the toolbox. Open its settings dialog and set parameters as follows. Column top, not linked. Column height, 3.15. Bottom elevation to project 0, minus 0.05. Rectangular structure. Size, 0.2 by 0.2. Building material. Timber, structural. Anchor point of core, middle. Tags. Load-bearing element. Exterior. Column. Layer, structural bearing. Click OK. Use the guidelines to create an imaginary intersection point for the first column. Activate a temporary blue guideline on the outer edge of the vertical wall by hovering the cursor over the edge. Click on the orange spot on the guideline. Drag the guideline to the right. Without releasing the orange spot, type 0.30 in the distance field of the tracker. Now, repeat the same on the outer edge of the horizontal wall and drag the guideline 2.0 meters from the wall edge. Click on the intersection point to place the first column. Create the same guideline geometry on the opposite side of the horizontal wall. Select the column and multiply it by activating the Multiply command from the context menu. Right-click and choose the Move, Multiply command. Alternatively, you can use the Edit, Move, Multiply menu command. Choose Drag as the Multiply action and enter 3 for the number of copies. Now select the Distribute Multiply method. Finally, click OK to proceed. Click the center point of the column, and with the Shift key pressed, move the cursor to the guideline. Click to place the three new columns if the lines are perpendicular. Hit Escape to deselect the columns. Checking in 3D, you can see that the exterior pavement is not wide enough. Let's adjust it. Select the slab and click on the side to show the pet palette commands. Click the offset edge command. And drag the edge by 2 meters so the pavement is under the columns as well. Now let's continue with the rafters. Switch back to the zero ground floor. Activate the section tool in the toolbox. And draw a section line vertically in the middle of the building. Click with the eye cursor to the left of the section line. Please note that the section will automatically appear in the section list of the Navigator. Double-click on the section in the Navigator to open it. Measure the distance between the top of the rafter and the zero level, so we will know where it should be placed precisely. You can use the measure tool on the standard toolbar. We'll take advantage of the automatic surface recognition when placing the beam. Switch to the 3D window and select the roof and open its settings. Turn off surface override for the side materials. Click OK. The skins of the roof are now visible. Activate the beam tool. Set its settings as follows: beam height and beam width, 0.2. Reference axis offset, 0.1. Inclined method, 18 degrees. Building material, timber, structural. Tags. Load-bearing element. Exterior. Beam. Layer. Structural. Bearing. We have not set the elevation of the beam. We will leave automatic surface recognition to do the job instead. Click OK. Select the single geometry method in the info box and click the bottom corner of the roof on the upper part of the rafter skin. And the top corner of the roof, again on the upper part of the rafter skin. After the beam is placed, open its settings to check the elevation and home story. ArchiCAD automatically placed the beam to the desired home story and elevation that we measured from the section earlier. Turn on surface override again for the roof when done. Open the gallery plan view. Select the already drawn rafter. Right-click on it and select Move, Multiply. In the Multiply dialog, enter 12 for number of copies. Choose the Distribute method and click OK. Click the top left corner of the rafter. Then, hold down the Shift key to constrain the mouse movement horizontally, and click the top left corner of the roof. Click anywhere on the empty screen, or press the Escape key to remove selection of newly created elements. Open the 3D window to see the result. Use the Orbit and Explore commands to navigate.